world. Good evening, Melanated Nation. Good evening, brothers and sisters. And once again, good evening, brothers and sisters. Good evening, North America, South America, Central America. Good evening to all our brothers and sisters over across in the UK, Australia, Motherland Africa, to all the Melanated Nation. And once again, welcome to the amazing show. Welcome to the Monday O Report. I'm your host, your humble servant, the one and only, the narrator himself, the Black Knight, Mr. O, as I come to y'all again with the Monday O Report. I know it had a total reboot. So let's just go ahead and just get started. Let's get right into this. Well, it didn't take long. A lot of things has been going since the 14 days of the Arkham Administration Asylum has been in effect, full effect. And I'm going to tell you something. It hasn't struck me as no surprise, once again, that anorexic human giraffe known as Sage Steel has made the news in reference to that, because, you know, the Muslim ban that that President Tangerine has signed from banning Muslims from other countries, particularly Syria, Yemen, Iran, Iraq, this and that, you know. But leaving out Pakistan and Saudi Arabia and all some other ones. Sage Steele has recently made the news and stuff. She was out here bitching and complaining about her her missing her flight at the LAX due to the fact you have protesters at airport all across the world that's upset about the whole ban and them from the airports and all this other stuff like that. You know, so this is the article. I think she went on her Twitter page and with her stupid shit. So I'm just gonna read this to you right here, cause you know I got the picture of the coon right there, or the bear witch right there. You know, she went on her Twitter page. I'm really not gonna really read the article, but let me just read to you exactly what she posted when she took the Instagram bitching and whining about her missing a flight. And this is from her Instagram page. So this is why thousands of us dragged luggage for nearly 2 miles to get to LAX but still missed our flights. Fortunately, a 7-hour wait for the next flight to Houston won't affect me that much, but my heart sank for the elderly and parents with small children who did their best to walk all that way but had no chance of making their flight. I love witnessing people exercising their right to protest, but it saddens me to see the joy on their faces that they were successful in disrupting so many people's travel plans. Yes, immigrants were affected by this as well. Brilliant. Yeah, so yeah, I mean, personally, that deal was basically selfish. It was stupid, and it was ignorant of her to even say that. But see, she's the one that want to try to get out there and wants to try to push that 1963 Martin Luther King junk about integration and all that. You know, you want to try to push the narrative for white acceptance. When in this day and age, it is so further from the truth. Let's just keep it real on that. just didn't go out notice, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, Black Twitter came out there and they literally roast the human giraffe. And, you know, let me just read a couple of tweets here. One from Taylor Rooks said, "Hey Sage, with all due respect, what type of protest do you prefer? The disruption is the point of protest." And another one from Natalie Camille, and she's saying, "As a business traveler, knowing that this was going on at the airport, maybe you should have allowed yourself more time." "And as a volunteer attorney who helped reunite a family this past weekend, your comments are stunning. Some things are bigger than you." Those are just a couple of tweets. She did fire back. That she said that stage still fire back. All good, but just because someone has a different opinion doesn't mean that, you know, this bitch just, she need to be dick slapped, to be honest with you. She is so fucking stupid. Very fucking stupid. You know. And I think you know, like I said, that's real selfish and very narcissistic of her. This ain't about you. Okay? It's things out here, it's issues out here in this world that's bigger than you. And see, this is what I meant the last time on one of my podcasts, what I said about when it comes to humanity. That nobody has no sense of humanity anymore. You know? Everybody just out here thinking about themselves. Which is so crazy. But then again, that's Sage still. I'm not really gonna spend too much time on this because she sounds so fucking stupid. If you wanna hear the ether of her, check out my girl Kimberly Frazier's channel on YouTube, on her podcast and all that. And she gave a good roasting of her. So with that on Sage still, let's just move on. You know, because this is pertaining to the Muslim ban and the wall. There's no doubt, and there's no surprise either, that, you know, and why Black people shouldn't even should care about it or shouldn't even get involved in it. You know, when it come down to the wall, where he said he's going to make this wall that's going to, excuse me, that's gonna ban illegal immigrants or whatever. I've seen a protest that's going all across, and I've seen a lot of people protesting about it. But as far as us as Black people, some of those same illegal immigrants, mostly being of Latin or Mexican descent, that called us every despicable word in the book, are now waking up and they start to realize they're starting to get their nigger moment, put it that way. Me personally, like I say, Black people shouldn't even be getting involved. See, that the problem with us, we always want to go ahead and want to jump into everybody else's cause and try to solve everybody else's problems. And we didn't never solve. We got our own problems that we have to solve. And see, that's the one thing that I fought President Obama on at that time. You know, you're trying to address everybody else's problem, but you weren't taking care of what matters here first. Take care of home first, then worry about everybody else's shit. So my thing, like, Like this, when it comes to the Muslim ban or when it comes to the wall, I'm not thinking about no wall. I'm not thinking about the Muslim ban. I feel for them and all that. They have to hold their own nuts as far as I'm concerned. Okay? You know, because I got friends that are Muslim friends and all that. Yes, I do feel for them. And me being as a Moorish American Muslim, M-O-S-L-E-M, I feel for that. But this is a time for us as collective, as indigenous, aboriginal, melanated humans to come together and go ahead and start building with us, you know. We're very much fully aware of what's going on. We're very much fully aware of the Arkham Asylum Administration, as I see fit to call them. You know. And the protesters and everything like that is good. It's supposed to cause disruption. It's supposed to make them uncomfortable. But this mutt, Sage Steel, fails to understand, overstand, or understand that because she's too busy swinging from daddy's pelvis like Tarzan on a vine. You know. But then again, that's why I say, like, you know, you can put it next to a giraffe and a Serengeti, you wouldn't know the difference. But this is my advice to black people. Stay the hell out of that. Let them go ahead and build that wall. Let them go ahead. Let them do what they're going to do anyway. Because the reason why I say this, you know what I'm saying, like this, because, see, they're trying to hold on to whatever little bit of power they have. Because guess what? Whites are slowly and surely becoming the minority. Okay, plain and simple. They already, as I stated before, their genes are recessive. They're dying out on a slowly but steady rate. White baby births are declining. White women don't want to get pregnant no more. They ain't, you know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, you know, it's got a virus that's going on in the water up there in Philadelphia where it's only affecting white women. So they're slowly dying out. They're slowly dying out. So I wouldn't even worry nothing about that. The best thing the best thing black people can just do, just sit back and watch the show and focus on building your own. Whether you going to school and you getting your education, you getting your degrees, do that. You go into your 9 to 5 and you clocking in at 8, 10, 12 hours plus overtime and a half, do that. Or so that way you can have your time to go ahead, instead of being employed, you can go ahead and build something so that way you can have businesses. Because we need to start focusing on us and start building an economic powerhouse. You know, do you realize, like I keep saying, that we have a $1.4 trillion spending power? But only 2% of that is coming back to the black community. As current right now, that is slowly... that percentage is going up. Because the other day I walked around through my neighborhood and speak with a lot of people, and what I see a lot more of our people shopping and doing business at a lot of black owned places. Went to the bank the other day, the bank which I bank is a black owned bank, and I see people there. I'm seeing more people coming in there waiting in the lobby, about like 5-10 people waiting in the lobby, getting accounts open, in and out. I mean, it's unbelievable, you know. So, you know, like I say, that's a good thing, you know, that's a great good thing. And then on top of that, you know, you got income tax coming around. Yeah, this is the time where all the ballers start to come out. Well, this is what I say to y'all. Don't be going out here buying, instead of y'all going out here buying rims for your cars, or going ahead and buying like a couple pair of Jordans, or or doing some other stuff, like getting inked up or some junk like that. Look here, take that money and go ahead and invest it in something. Take it to a black-owned bank, invest it in a black-owned investment firm or somewhere like that. Do the research, Google it up. That's what Google's there for. Well, Scroogle, I call them. Well, DuckDuckGo, which is better secured, you go ahead and you use that. Let's just go ahead and focus on us, you know, because I know for a fact through social media, I know it's a lot of people that's out here being trumpeteers, I should say, you know, both black and white. But there's no doubt in my mind, yes, I mean, the things he's doing at an alarming rate, signing executive order after executive order after executive order after executive order after executive order, you know, it's basically really demoralizing. But we cannot be afford to be distracted by the ignorant comments of the giraffe known as Shay Steele, fuck her, or the Muslim ban, or the wall. We ain't got time for that. This is the time now for us to go ahead and have tunnel vision, to focus on us, okay? Get your ish together. You know, never mind about waiting till the weekend to go to the club on South Beach and make it rain, or popping bottles, make it rain into that black-owned bank, pop some bottles up in there. That's what the hell you need to do. Besides, a lot of other things are gonna be going on. We just seeing what we looking at is the tip of the iceberg. We looking at some other problems that we have to deal with as black people in our community. We have to deal not only with the police brutality by race soldiers disguised as law enforcement officers who happen to be law enforcement, the enforcement arm of white supremacy, with their Grand Cyclops, one of the Grand Cyclops, Steve Bannon, you know, with that. Plus, you got to deal with some of them in the DA's office and in the judges' chambers, so you got to deal with that. It's in addition, sitting up there in the mayor's or commissioner's or governor's seats. But we also have to deal with other guests that move their businesses into the black community and doesn't show no respect. But see, all of them are now happen to be pretty quiet when I walk into them stores now. In the Arab-owned stores or some of these quote-unquote Hispanic-owned stores that's in the black communities. You know, because about what's going to happen. Even the mayor here in Miami-Dade, Carlos Jimenez, even he has to comply with the terms of the immigration ban. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not even worried much about that either. I'm aware of it. Not worried about that. My biggest thing I worry about, excuse me, is the gentrification. That's the biggest thing that's going on there. That's what we have to deal with. So, brothers, some of y'all brothers who got those ends like that or whatever, y'all need to start putting that and use it to strategize for the benefit of y'all community. Instead of going ahead and buying those inanimate objects that I mentioned earlier, why not try to pull y'all resources as a collective and try to go ahead and buy the block? What I mean buy the block, buy some buildings that, you know, that's abandoned or whatever, and then turn them into businesses that'll benefit the black communities. You know, that'll benefit black communities like Overtown, Liberty City, Opa-locka, Miami Gardens, well, still call it Carroll City, you know, or any other local spots like Robin Hood, Largemont, Little Haiti. You know, Little Haiti, you take a look at the blueprint there. They got theirs together. Okay? Or Brownsville, you know, a.k.a. Brown Sub. That's what they need to be trying to do, because that's a surefire way. You can go here and you can create an economic base. You can create jobs. You can create a lot of things right there. And on top of that, you also stave off gentrification as well. Because see, as long as if you have a community that's basically economically fundamentally sound, economically sound, it'll make transition and go ahead and renegotiate or whatever with other groups. I'm not saying to go ahead and separate ourselves from that. I never said that. You know, there's always room to open dialogue, because I never have a problem sitting across the table from somebody to go ahead and have a dialogue with that person or persons, plural. You know, whether I don't have to like them or agree with them or not, I don't have a problem sitting across them like that. We can always agree to disagree. Because, see, when it comes down to me, it's always going to be me being part of the B1 Brigade. That's just going to be like this. But now, if you're going to start talking that hot sauce and pepper junk, prepare to go ahead and get ethered in more than one ways. I guarantee you that. Because this shit's about to get, this is going to get serious. This is going to get real serious. Because see, you're not going to get it from these coons or these bear winches, and their usefulness has already going to be expired. Just ask Stacey Trash. Just ask Chrisette Michelle. There's a few others that's going to be gone too. Or better yet, just ask Steve Harvey how the ratings on his show, on his radio show, has dropped since meeting with President Cheeto. But I'm not finna go ahead and eat the no coons on the Monday O Report. Don't got time for that. I say that for Coon Hunters Thursdays. That's my thing like that. But that's a thing that we gotta do. That's why I say I wouldn't even be worrying about no ban, no Muslim ban, worry about no wall. I'm not even thinking about that. I tell you what you need to do. If you want to find ways how to do it, tune in. You know, the Dr. Boyce Watkins channel. He has a YouTube channel over, I think, almost 200,000 followers. So, and you know, that brother there will be spitting some good advice. Especially when you're talking about investing in the stock market for $5 a day or $5 a month. I got to look more into that one myself, because I'm interested in there as well. Because that's another thing we need to start doing, black people. We need to start going ahead and looking into the stock market too. Because stocks has gone up since Trump has been elected. So this is the best time to go ahead and try to take advantage of something like that. Because we always missing out. You know, you want to get out here, you want to talk about reparations. Here's the thing, I'm not looking for reparations. I'm just looking for just compensation. And that's what we need to go ahead and focus on. But see, the thing is about it, let me just go on a little historical and lawful trip. You know, when it comes down to the term black, yes, I'm using a lot here. But that's just only as a term of communication. I don't use it as in to define race or nationality. Neither does white. because, you know, I've noticed I changed the vocabulary. I refer to those pinks as just being who they are, Caucasians, being descendants of the people from the Caucasus Mountains, or the caves and mountains, caves of the Caucasus Mountains. So just call them for what they are. That's the thing about Whitney. Because I've heard many of these leaders, many of your so-called appointed black leaders, Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, the Big Six, you know, John Lewis, A. Philip Randolph, Whitney Young, Roy, Martin Luther King, James Farmer, Randolph Phillips, Roy Wilkins, those guys. They're all dead except for Lewis. He's still sitting up there. His only claim to fame. Don't you see these knots on my head? And all this stuff. Oh, God. I don't even like mentioning that dude. You know. Still buck dancing nearly 50 years later. Wow. But see, they tell y'all about saying being black and all this stuff like that, but black is not a nationality. Neither is white, neither is Hispanic. But you also gotta understand too, reparations, nah. We shouldn't be trying to look for reparations. We should be just getting just compensation. And it's major. It's very major compensation that we need to receive. If we got to go in there and take it, then damn it, that's the what the hell that we gonna do. We gonna go in there, we gonna take it. But let me just go ahead and round this up right quick for you before I'm a little short on time today. Let's just focus on ourselves, you know. Because Boyce Walker's brought up a very interesting term, reciprocity. Yeah, remember that key word, reciprocity. Reciprocity. Sorry about that. A little bit under the weather. Reciprocity. Because it's a case of, like, you know, what have you done for me lately and stuff like that. Ladies, you need to remember that one too. I'll throw the definition of that word up on my Black Spot page and in my Twitter feed, in case y'all want to see. Or add on my Instagram page. So I'm going to throw it up right there just to give y'all a redefining of that. Yeah, because I deal with them more. I don't be on Facebook. Don't got time for that. Or Fedbook, I call them. Because that slowly but surely is going to be phased out. But that's what we need to do. We focus on us. Everything else be fine. Now on a personal footnote, you know, focus on your families. Focus, black men, y'all need to step up and start becoming men and start becoming head of your households and stuff like that. You know, quit acting like some damn goons or whatever like that. Get goonish when it comes down to dealing with these old rogue ass crackers that think they can want to go ahead and put hands on you. Yes, and I'm going to call it like it is. I'm not softening my stance referring to these fuckers as who they are. Okay? And start being men of the household. You know what I'm saying? Just go ahead and do what y'all need to do, whatever, to maintain your household, maintain your family, more importantly, maintain your dignity and your integrity, and you know, and let your nuts hang, man. Just let them hang. Let your nuts hang, man. Let them swing like coconuts from a coconut tree. Feel me? Just let them swing. And do what you need to do. You know? Do what you need to do. KGDC. But don't coon. Don't conform. Don't coon. And sisters, look. You see that brother trying to do right, and he trying to do right not only by himself, but trying to do right by you. Then you need to get behind him on that. You need to get behind him on that, period. I'm not even thinking about no cave thinkies. I'm really not. dudes that's messed up with them, that's on them. We can't do nothing about that. Can't really do nothing about that. You know, let's just go on here. Let's do that individually, and then, you know, we also at the same time we come as a collective, okay? Because keeping the fact in the mind that, you know, we are spiritual people that's having a human experience. Spiritual beings who having a human experience, not the other way around. But one thing it is whole true. This war that you see here, it is spiritual. It's on so many levels that even some brothers I talk to that want to try to think they know, or they think they're authorities on this, they still can't see past their damn nose to understand, overstand, or even understand. But I save that for another time, though. You know, I got like 2 minutes left. But say still, fuck you. Self-righteous piece of shit. Bitch, all you doing is thinking about yourself. You ain't thinking about nobody else. You ain't giving a shit. Fuck you. And the same thing goes for a lot of other ones. To my people, don't worry about no ban. Don't worry about no wall. We ain't even thinking about that. Let's focus on us. Let's focus on us. I don't care who you are, whether you're Moors, whether you're a Nation of Islam, whether you're a 5%er, whether you're Masons, Christian, Muslim, RBG, Pan-African, you know, Umar Johnson type, whatever like that, you know, hey, put that shit to the side. That shit there, that's petty. We need to start coming as a collective and stuff like that. No more debates, although they're interesting, but they're counterproductive. Okay? The only one who really making money off of that is the one who running the damn camera behind the scenes. Ain't that right, Franklin Gehry? That's all that's about. You got time for that. Just gonna conclude my broadcast for the evening. I just wanted to go ahead and throw my little 2 cents in there. If y'all want to check me out, man, shout out. Go ahead and support the Black Spot, man. The Black Spot happens to be black-owned, black-operated social networking site. Excellent alternative to Facebook. And the update, yeah, they're over 8,000 members strong and counting. I wouldn't be surprised they reach 9,000 and counting. You know, we going for that number one spot. You know, the trolls tried to come in there from Facebook to try to stop them, but it couldn't happen. Won't happen. Can't stop, won't stop. Okay? So, you know, go check that out. Also, you got another one called Black Junction. That's also black owned and black operated as well. You know, check that out. But right now, it's Black Spot as well. It's popping. I'm over there. As well as Dr. Boyce Watkins is over there. Cynthia G is over there. The Advice Show is over there. Several others. You know what I'm saying? They're coming up with another major update. The Android app is getting totally revamped. At the same time, there's going to be an update for those who got the iPhones or iPads. So it's going to be iOS coming very, very shortly. So with that said, I'm your host, your humble servant, the one and only, the Black Knight, and also known now as the narrator, Mr. O, host the amazing show. Thank y'all for listening to the Monday O Report. With that said, love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. It ain't John Cornelius, but close enough. James, let's ride.